Here with me now, we have Utah Congressman Chris Stewart. He's a Republican on the House Intelligence Committee. You've heard a lot of the outrage from these senators, in particular Lindsey Graham, Bob Corker. When you look at this, especially Lindsey Graham saying that he said if Secretary Mattis and Secretary Pompeo, who gave the initial briefing on the Khashoggi murder, which the White House is trying to minimize, he said that if they were Democrats, he would have said they were in the pocket of Saudi Arabia. But because he respects them, he's going to assume they're being good soldiers.
Well, I think there's another possible explanation, and that is that we just have more information, or more information was provided to these senators. I can tell you that sitting on the House Intel Committee, what
he made it clear that wasn't the case. He made it clear that this was open source information. So it's not like there was more information that came to light in the matter of a few days. That does not seem to be the case.
I still think that's a possibility.
You think that's
he
a possibility?
He doesn't know what others were provided is the thing. He knows what he was provided. But I can tell you that
but that's key, isn't it? If he was not provided it by the defense secretary?
Well, it could be, though, because there was more information learned. I can tell you that last week, the information we were provided by the agency was not definitive. And I know that the senator doesn't believe this, but if someone is saying that Secretary Mattis or Secretary Pompeo were dishonest, they just don't know those individuals. There's no way in the world those individuals came out
well,
and lied because they did.
He does know. He certainly knows Mike Pompeo.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's trying, says he's giving him the benefit of the doubt. But if he didn't know them, if he wasn't friendly with them, he would say they were in the pocket of Saudi Arabia.
Well, once again, I just think there's another simple explanation, and one that I think is plausible.
And actually, you know that's true, or it's possible?
Well, we, without having sat in both briefings, and the senator didn't, and neither did I, without having said in both briefings, no one can say, well, this was briefed here, and this was also
briefed here. But as a member of the Intel Committee knowing... you're saying, but then if nobody can know, then you don't actually have a factual basis for that assertion. You're just saying you believe that's a plausible...
I think that's a possibility.
So you think it's a possibility, but you're not sure.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Okay, all right, just want to be clear there. What happens now when you have senators who feel very differently than you do? You're giving them the benefit of the doubt. He said he's going to believe they're good soldiers. There are clearly senators who believe that something was covered up here from what they and this is all with the background happening of the Trump administration or President Trump essentially saying maybe the Saudis did it, maybe they didn't. He doesn't care.
I think the more important question, look, we can go back over the last few weeks and wonder and I think eventually conclude, well, this is the information that was provided to these groups at this time. At this point, this is what we now know. I think that's the most important consideration. And the question is, what do we do now?
Sure.
Because we've got a couple of very perplexing problems. The first is this, and it's simple, and that is we have to have a relationship with some players that we don't agree with. Journalists disappear all over the country. 20 journalists have been killed in Mexico. You don't think it's happened in Turkey and China? Of course it does. And yet we have to have a relationship with these individuals or with these countries. And the second thing is this. What is in the best interest of the United States? And this is a very, very difficult challenge because we have to, on one hand, hold them accountable, including the Crown Prince, for whatever action he may have been involved with. And at the same time, what is protecting U.S. interests? What is going to counter Shia extremists? What is going to help bring stability? What will help bring an end to the war in Yemen? You have to balance all of those considerations as we move forward on this.
But as the administration moves forward, isn't there a commitment to telling the truth? Because it seems like the what is bothering these senators, bipartisan among them, including folks who have supported Saudi Arabia and who have supported the Trump administration, is that the Trump administration has turned a blind eye to the facts here.
Well, I just don't think we know that that's true at all. And having worked in this area for...
How could you not say that the president has turned a blind... He literally said in his statement, maybe they did, maybe they didn't, and then he said that Saudi Arabia needs to be supported.
Because new information may have emerged. I mean, that's a very possible explanation.
This was at the time he essentially said maybe they did and he doesn't care.
Well, I don't think he said he doesn't care. But
he said maybe they didn't.
I just don't think you're focusing on the thing that matters here. I mean, it's very possible, and you can't deny this, it's very possible that new information has emerged. I'm telling you, what I was briefed last week was very different than what these senators were apparently briefed on. I haven't had that briefing. And it's very possible. You don't have all of the intel all of the time, and you don't have all of the analysis of the raw information that you do have immediately. Sometimes that takes a little bit of time. I think that's a possible explanation for this. Putting that aside, wouldn't we agree the most important thing is, what do we do with this now?
Should the president change his tune on this?
Well, it depends on what you mean by changes, too.
Should the president consider looking critically at Saudi Arabia instead of saying, hey, there's money at stake, this essentially is not of concern to me, because that, I think, is a fair paraphrasing of what he said.
Absolutely. That's an absolutely appropriate response for him to have if this new information would point directly.
We don't know it's new information. I just have to be clear. We do not know that this is new information. We just know this is information coming from the CIA, which it assessed previous to that last briefing where you're saying maybe information changed. Prior to that initial briefing, the CIA was saying that they with high likeliness, they were concluding that MBS was behind this.
And again, I think we're straining the gnat and swallowing a camel. Let's decide what is the important response here. Your question is, should the president change his response to this? I would say that he should. I think all of us agree there needs to be an appropriate response here. We need to hold individuals accountable. And we need to completely understand the facts regarding that as well.